Okay, welcome to part 3 of the responsive design tutorial. In that part we will discuss a very easy to use item, a very simple one, and this is called the FlexDisplay. And the FlexDisplay basically allows you to turn off and on this certain elements, groups, depending on the media what it's displayed. In the example here on the web page, we see that the shows a yellow square on the mobile mode and a blue one on tablet and a red one on desktop. Pretty amazing. Okay, let's go back to our designer tool here. I already have uploaded the flex size script action here. You always have to keep an eye if it's an extension item or a script action. Script actions always belong to the actions tab and then user defined account. Script actions, the extension items go to the layout tab. So let's look how this works. As I promised you, it's pretty easy. So when we have a group here and we, for example, add a headline to that, and we say, okay, this is mobile. Let's suppose I only want to show this whole group on a mobile device. I go to actions, I pick my flex display action, and this flex display action shows me 3 checkboxes, that's all. It couldn't be easier. So I can say this particular item here, in that case, this group should be shown on desktop, no. Should be shown on tablet, no. And when I make the area smaller here, so with a width that equals a mobile width, I see this is mobile. So let's add another item, what we want to show maybe on the tablet device or on the desktop device. I take this image with this guy playing blues up, what's actually me. And I group this and drag another flex display action on here, but this time, I set the mobile display to false, so I uncheck this checkbox, and obviously the image disappears, but it's visible on tablet and desktop. I think that's it. It's a pretty simple thing, but it could help you whenever you run into problems with the other pretty cool responsive stuff, that it is not enough, that you need really different designs, different visibility for the different devices, and you can't achieve that with the flex grid or the flex image stuff. So therefore you always can say I do the layout, parts of the layout 2 times, once for the mobile and once for the desktop version, and then you use the switch. So thanks for listening. We will come back with part 4 shortly and talk about the remaining items.